So I wanted to do a segment called Lens to Lens. So this is where two cameras are compared for obvious reasons because they're similar in use, but somehow one is either newer in time or a different manufacturer or so forth. So let's look at these two Leicas. So this is the Leica M2 and the Leica IIIa. So we'll notice some major differences at the beginning, film advance, the scale at which the shutter speed progresses is different, and the lower speeds are on the lower transmission down here. These are two Leicas from vastly different time periods. This one takes a screw mount lens, so the lens is literally screwed on the face in a twist motion. Now, what's cool about this is this lens goes on this camera. However, this is an M-mount lens. This lens doesn't go on this camera, so it's forwards convertible, but not backwards convertible, or is it the other way? So I guess it's this lens is backwards convertible this. Either way, the screw mount lenses go on the M-mount. The M-mounts don't go on the screw mounts. Now, let's get these cameras on their back because we talked about the shutter speeds. So this is using the 1500, 200, 100, and this is 1500, 250, 125th. And we'll notice that the Leica M2 has, on some options, a self-timer. That's quite nice. And the viewfinder. Okay, some big differences there in the viewfinder. We've got a lot more eyes on this one than this one. This one, the viewfinder's integrated and can take 35mm lenses. This one, 50mm lens, viewfinder only. And as we flip it over on the back, we'll notice the 3A, well, it has two windows. They're not even close to together. They're just two windows. The Leica M2, one window. Now, some of the features we will note are similar, and that's the film rewind. That's same the same. The shutter actuator, the shutter button. This one's threaded. This one's not. Lever, no lever. But the film counter, this one has clicks, and this one just glides around. So to advance, you twist there. The rewind is a lever here, and the lever's pulled out on the front on this one. So this viewfinder, although you can't see it, it has parallax or parallax error correction. This one does not. And the backs. Well, this window here is actually significantly easier to load, and this is significantly more difficult. So the bottom of these cameras have the same Leica system where you pull a little tab up and they pull off the bottom to make sure it's not loaded. Okay. And then the back comes off and there is a take-up spool. So by no means is this a fast way to load a camera, but it was a lot faster than any other way, and it's a solid mechanism. The mechanism on this is unbeatable as far as tough construction goes, and it's an interesting way to load film. Obviously, more modern cameras in the Japanese style were going to load from the back with a swinging door. These do not. So, why would you get this when this is available? Well, because it's fun to have these. This could be significantly cheaper than a Leica M2 or any of the other Leica M series, and these cameras still take great photos because they have Leica lenses. Now, these lenses are older, and even this lens even has an older aperture scale. It starts at 2, 2.2, 3.2, 4.5, 6.3. It's not the same scale that we're used to. Whereas the modern Voigtlander lenses have the regular aperture progression. So can you get that for this? Well, yeah, because Voigtlander made screw mount lenses and they work just fine with the rangefinder mechanism in this camera. It's the same rangefinder there. And the close focus is going to be the same as the Leica M3, as far as I can tell. It's about 1 meter. Whereas the Leica M2 close focus is 0.7 meters. So you're getting a little better on your close focus here. So both are cool, but this one has a little bit slower controls as far as film advance go, but you still get your full 1/1000th of a second down to 1 second range, just in a slightly different scale than we're used to. Now, this one does not have a flash sync, and they didn't until later. Some of the Leica screw mounts do, but only the later ones do. And this one does have a flash sync, which is convenient, but to be honest, most of the time I use my Leicas without a flash. Only rarely do I use a flash, but I have the PC sync adapter on this so that I could. And occasionally I do. And you'll notice that I have a Voigtlander lens on my Leica. And that's because this is an affordable 35mm lens, and I wanted to try out 35mm. I had a 50, and I wanted to try the 35mm out, and it's an M lens and still made, and we'll review that another day. So, both classic cameras, both collectors and different reasons would like, but obviously more advanced on the M2, like a screw mount, less desirable for some reasons, but still a very fun camera to shoot. And I don't think I'll ever get rid of it. This one belonged to a friend of mine before I bought it from him, and I've enjoyed shooting with it for many years. It likely needs some sort of CLA, but we'll see when we get to that point. So they shoot very well, and they're built like tanks for sure. If I had my choice and I could only have one, oh, I'd definitely have the Leica M2. But this was significantly more affordable than the Leica M2. If you want to try out a rangefinder camera and see sort of what it's all about, I'm not sure it'd be a bad way to go. I think that if you're going to start shooting film and you're okay with the principle that film is going to be slower, then you understand that this is a camera that's going to be slower for many reasons. The knob and the shutter speed scale, it's completely different. I mean, everything about this camera is essential for shooting. Aperture, shutter speed, focus, knob, wind. But this is a much easier camera to shoot with on, say, your vacations, something like that. Not that this is impossible, but this one is just much easier to shoot with. If you have any more questions about the Leica M2 versus the Leica 3A, let me know in the comments down below, and I'll try and get more of these episodes out. I thought it would be fun to compare some cameras sort of lens to lens, head to head, and see what they do.